Hello, in this video I'm going to talk to you about a project of mine called Flock. Flock is part of a bigger site that I'm making called Bimble Space. The whole site is something that I started making during 2020 lockdown. I thought it would be like a fun project to keep me occupied, but also making something else for people to interact with. So it's a website full of interactive browser toys, which means that they are things that they're like websites that you can just open up and interact with in your browser and experience them and just kind of play around and have some fun with. In Flock, there are kind of two parts. First of all, you can choose a color and you can draw bubbles around the screen by dragging your mouse or dragging your finger. Once they've been created, the bubbles actually respond to each other in their movements and they travel kind of like a flock of birds or a school of fish would. The second part of the idea is the pairing, which means that if two people are there at once, they get paired up and they can play together. So whenever you draw bubbles, your partner sees those bubbles and you see the bubbles that your partner is drawing. And that means that you can interact with each other and your bubbles form a flock together and will move around the screen together. So I like to think that this multi-user interaction is kind of a lockdown-friendly way to make a connection with a stranger. Shared interaction is something that I've been working with for quite a while as an artist, with the goal of creating group experiences. So we're used to interacting with a computer, like our laptop or our phone, kind of one-on-one. It's like one human and one computer, like me and my phone or you and your laptop. But what I'm interested in is seeing how multiple people can interact with the same system at once. You might have heard about the idea of flow. This is a state that an individual enters when they're immersed in an activity and you get lost in the moment because of what you're doing. Similar to this, I think, is a state called swing, which is when people connect to each other through a collective experience and become immersed in a group. So with flow, you're immersed in the activity, and with swing, you're immersed in the group. And this term was coined actually talking about teams of rowers in a boat. What I have found is that shared interaction in this way and group experiences can lead to a human connection even between complete strangers. With Flock in particular, there's a knowledge that another person is seeing your movements, and maybe you're even touching the same spots on your phone screen, and that leads to a feeling of connection despite the physical distance. While there are no predefined goals or rules for this game, people immediately began to invent their own, and they told me about that they were finding ways to communicate with their partner by mimicking each other's movements or like circling around one another. Or drawing symbols like hearts or less wholesome things. And I heard about some people holding their fingers still in the same spot while the bubbles kind of billow out everywhere. And they said that it was like a virtual hug. The animations are created in P5.js. Communication between participants uses nodejs and it sends messages using socket.io. The site itself is hosted and run on Heroku. So I'll just kind of go through those and tell you a little bit more detail. P5.js is a library for JavaScript. It's similar to processing, if you've ever heard of that or used it. And you create a canvas and then you can draw things on that canvas. And it's specifically for creating graphical and interactive experiences. I also want to talk a little bit about the flocking algorithm itself. That flocking algorithm is based on a paper by a guy called Craig Reynolds. I've been talking about bubbles, but he refers to these little creatures as boids. And basically how it works is that in every frame, every boid or bubble, checks on the position of every other one, and then it looks at the ones that are nearby and considers their direction and their position, and then it adjusts its own movement based on that. So there are three ways in which it does that, three steering behaviors we call them. And in the code you can kind of weight these different forces, like give them a different strength. The first one is separation, so that is steering to avoid your neighbors so that you don't crash. Second one is alignment, So that is steering towards the average direction of your neighbors. And the third one is cohesion. So that is steering towards the average position of your neighbors. Or you can kind of balance the three forces. So you have kind of a natural flocking behavior that is more similar to a flock of birds, which is what I've done here. I also use Perlin Noise to add a little bit of wiggle to the movement of the bubbles to just help them feel a little bit more alive. So Perlin Noise, it'll generate a number between 0 and 1. But if you were getting completely random numbers, you might get 0, then 0.9, then 0.7, then 0.2, then 0.5, and it would just be like all over the place. But with Perlin Noise, it's more like a smooth gradient between those numbers, and that adds quite a nice natural looking wiggle to the movement of the voids. And in my code, you can also weight how much that wiggle is affecting the movement. So here you can see what it's like if the wiggle is super strong. The communication between different browsers is done using nodejs, and node again is JavaScript, but instead of running on the client side like p5.js, it runs on the server side. So that means that the p5.js runs on the browser, so that's like on the user's computer, and nodejs runs on a server, and that server is hosted elsewhere, and it's run on Heroku, which is a cloud service. And then I use socket.io to send messages back and forth between the client and the server. So when a new user joins, they can choose to be paired up. And if no one else is there at the time, they'll get added to a waiting list. And then when another person joins who also wants to be paired up, they will get joined together. And then anytime that either of them draws, information about the bubbles that they're creating is sent to the other person via the Node.js server. When I first had this idea, you know, I knew it was possible that people would find this kind of human connection aspect touching. I played the game Journey, and in that you kind of get matched up with other people randomly sometimes, and you can only communicate with them by like running around each other or by singing. And by singing, it's just like you let out these tones, and you do find ways to communicate back and forth with one another. And people have found Journey to be very moving, like the connection that you feel with this other person, even though your communication is so limited. So based on that, I was kind of thinking that maybe a similar thing could happen here, but kind of a lower definition, but still moving. But I didn't really have any way to test that, because I can test the technical side, I can check that the messages are being sent back and forth, and maybe even like I tried it with my flatmates, and you know, we checked that it was working from machine to machine, but I couldn't really test in any way if with a stranger would you feel like something meaningful was happening. So I didn't know that. And then additionally, I've been working on this for several weeks, and at the start I didn't have the flocking behavior. I just had bubbles would kind of fly out of your mouse and wiggle off and then disappear, and you could see that happening from the other person's screen and your own mouse movements as well, but it didn't have the flocking. And then as soon as I added the flocking in, I started to run into frame rate issues, because with flocking, every single bubble is checking on every other bubble every single frame. So if you have 400 bubbles, that's 160,000 checks every single frame. So a lot of machines are going to struggle to do that at 60 frames a second. And then once the frame rate drops, you start to get like jerky animation. So I had to start reducing the number of bubbles. So the way I did that, I actually wrote some code that checks on the frame rate and then reduces the maximum number of bubbles if the frame rate drops. And if the maximum number of bubbles is reached, then you can't draw more, and also the older bubbles will start shrinking and deleting. This means that faster machines can see more bubbles. As long as their frame rate is keeping up, they'll see higher numbers of bubbles, and slower machines will see fewer bubbles, but it will still act smoothly. But even kind of with that graceful degradation, even on fast machines, like the flocking algorithm really does affect the frame rate and it slows stuff down. So I had to kind of remove some of the detail in the aesthetics that I'd made. So I guess I was just kind of feeling like it didn't look as great aesthetically as it had done. And I guess I'd been staring at it too long and I just wasn't that into it anymore. And as I said, I just had no idea how it would be to interact with a stranger on this. So when I posted it on Reddit, I just had no idea. Like, I honestly didn't think that it would get picked up at all.
But it was actually really popular. It got a lot of upvotes, and now it has had over 32,000 unique page views just to the Flock page. And most of that happened between the 14th and the 15th of May. So the 14th is when I posted it, and the traffic shot up, and then it was doing really well on the 15th as well, and then it dropped off the front page, and then immediately the traffic drops off.
I can also look into the events because I added a Google event tag to a lot of stuff in my JavaScript. So if I look into pairing, it says here that there have been about 86,000 pairs, but that's actually tagged from both users' browsers. So we can divide it in half. So there was about 43,000 different pair events that happened in that time. And I think that's really cool just to think about all the different people that were paired up and the interactions that they will have had together.
So I'm just going to include a few quotes here from the Reddit thread. I'm aware that this is just completely bragging, but I do feel like this was really successful, and one of the, well, not even one of, but honestly my favorite thing about creating art, whether it's online or more often for me it's real world installations, like the best thing is seeing other people enjoy it and knowing that I have given people an experience that they otherwise wouldn't have had, and especially if that experience can include connection with another human, that is really meaningful to me. So I just want to share with you some of the feedback that I got. I did get a couple of pieces of feedback of like suggestions for improvements. So one thing was people asked for the option to not get paired up. I think some people, when they came to the site and they saw that they'd been paired with another person, that was kind of like a shock to them. And I think some people even mentioned that it had given them some anxiety, which I can completely understand, to be honest. And so I added in an option where at the start you get presented with the option to not get paired up. And in the analytics, I can see that I think maybe like 10 to 20% of people are choosing that option. And then quite a lot of those people will then change mode and get paired up afterwards as well. So it's kind of nice to know that I've like facilitated that option for them. And then the other thing that people wanted is a way to say goodbye. Some people were drawing hearts to say goodbye, which is actually a thing that happens in Journey as well. Like, people will run in a heart shape to draw a shape in the sand. So I thought it was kind of nice that people were doing that in Flock as well. But I understand that it is quite hard to draw shapes because I deliberately, for like internet relevant reasons, made it quite hard to draw specific shapes. I didn't want people to be able to spell things out or draw things that wouldn't be like kid appropriate. Like, I wanted the whole thing to be family friendly. So I added in this option where you can say goodbye, and then hopefully your partner will say goodbye as well, and then you can kind of leave feeling like the experience has ended nicely. So for me, the most interesting bit of this project and the thing that I want to develop more is the multi-user interactions, especially because at the moment, you know, we can't interact in person. So I'm trying to find stuff where it's like beautiful and fun and I can get some of that aesthetic back in without having to worry about the frame rate so much. So kind of having that in mind from the beginning, I think, will help me. As well as that, I do also want to create a version of the like Flock algorithm, which maybe, well, probably is single player, where you can have a bit of control over the flocking algorithm, and in the browser you would be able to adjust the alignment, separation and cohesion yourself, and maybe you could create two or three different types of creatures that have different properties and will act in different ways and see how they end up interacting with each other. So I think that kind of could be a fun idea as well, even though it doesn't do the multi-user interaction. I think it might be quite fun and easy to put together. So hopefully I'll get that online within the next couple of months. So do let me know in the comments below what you think of those ideas. Make sure to subscribe to me here for more videos, and also follow me on Instagram because I tend to post projects there when they are live, and I also post a lot of behind the scenes stuff as well, like I'm talking about things as I'm creating them, so you can kind of follow along the process if that's something that you're interested in. And in the meantime, check out in.bimble.space/vlog. Thanks.